And so this is a model that you may have seen before, right? If we think about equality, the picture on the left is a sort of visual representation of what equality looks like. Equality is essentially giving everyone the same thing. And so even though the young man in the blue shirt is taller, he actually has a better view than his two partners on his right. The young man in the red shirt has a view, but it is not as good as the young man on the left. And the young man on the far right, because he has the same thing as his other two, actually still can't see the game, right? If we shift to the right side of the slide, then equity is giving more to those who have less, right? That is, equity is sort of balancing the playing field, and it might mean providing greater resources or greater attention to those who have the least. And in order for them all to see the game equally, it might mean that the young man in the blue shirt doesn't have a box, but he can still see the game. But the young man on the right needs two boxes in order to see the game. So equity is about providing the resources that are necessary to provide an equal experience of life. Now, the next slide pushes us a little bit in terms of our thinking about insight and action, right? The next slide says, well, what might liberation look like, right, if we didn't have any barriers at all? And that if we remove the fence entirely, we remove the barriers entirely, then liberation might mean that they can all enjoy and participate in the game without any interruptions. The question that I pose to you is, what's in the next box? We've seen what equality is. We've seen what equity is. We have a vision of liberation. What might the fourth box look like? So the reason that we do this in terms of sort of how do we begin to think about insight and action is I think that oftentimes we have blind spots to our insight and action. One of the greatest casualties of oppression, one of the greatest casualties of injustice, is not blocked opportunities, but the greatest casualty of injustice and oppression is a threat to our imagination. It's a threat to hope. And the reason I say that is because when we talk about equity or equality, equity, and liberation, and then what comes next, sometimes our imagination is still connected to the form of oppression. That is, in some of our conversations, that the through line is somehow a form of participation, greater participation and less participation. And that is shaped by that form of oppression, which is exclusion. So another way that I'd like to sort of push folks is, how can you begin to think about that fourth box by divorcing that fourth box from any notion of participation? That is, that we don't have, that we're not thinking about that fourth box as simply greater forms of participation, but the fourth box is something entirely different. So if I put the word joy in that box, what would the picture look like? If I put love in that box, what would the picture look like? If I put happiness in that box, what would that picture look like? If I put flourishing in that box, what would the picture look like? The reason I use those terms is because love, joy, happiness, flourishing are not in response to oppression, but it actually allows us to have a quantum leap in our imagination about what comes after liberation.